Welcome back to the Buce Plant Channel, where we cover everything aquascaping and we try and entertain and inspire you along the way. My name is Logan with Team Buce Plant, and today we are tackling the very complicated topic of water parameters and water chemistry. But in the typical Buce Plant fashion, we're gonna keep it as simple and user-friendly as possible and just give you the very practical basics that you need to run a successful planted aquarium. Now, before we dive into the topic, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for lots more great content like this. Now let's get started. Water quality is almost infinitely complex. When you're dealing with water chemistry, there is a lot to think about. But the common parameters that you are going to hear about in the aquascaping hobby are pH, TDS, GH, and KH. In addition to these common parameters, you also have nitrite, ammonia, and nitrate levels. However, we already covered this in our How to Cycle an Aquarium episode, so go ahead and check that out. That'll be linked down below in the description, as well as at the card at the end of the video. So why should you even think about pH, TDS, GH, and KH in the first place? Well, these are the typical parameters you want to keep an eye on that essentially determine what is dissolved in your water. Because all organisms that live underwater, fish, shrimp, snails, and plants, they all need certain minerals and elements to really thrive. So by having a good idea of what is actually in your water, because not all water is created equal, you give yourself the best opportunity for running a successful tank, and then you can strategically keep the species that work. Now, in today's episode, we're going to cover each and every one of these parameters, what they mean and how to adjust them. However, if you want to keep a very specific species that maybe requires very hard water or a super duper low pH, we always recommend that you do your research very thoroughly and make a decision based on exactly what that species needs. But for today's episode, we're going to give you information and recommendations that work for most of the plants, fish, and shrimp that you keep in the aquascaping hobby. So you've probably heard of pH before. pH is essentially how acidic or how basic water is. And what actually determines water's acidity or basicity are how many hydrogen ions are floating around in that water. So the more positively charged hydrogen ions you have in the water, the more acidic it is, the lower the pH. The fewer positively charged hydrogen ions that you've got floating around in your water, the more basic it is. I know that sounds a little bit complicated, but all you really need to know is low pH equals acidic, and high pH equals basic. And in the aquascaping hobby, most of the organisms we keep, the fish, plants, shrimp, and snails, they prefer pHs in the 6.5 to the 7.5 range. So most of you in the planted aquarium hobby will find that your water falls somewhere here. Occasionally you'll have tap water that is more in the extreme end. So this is just something you want to test when you get your water and make sure that it falls into the acceptable levels. However, it's not the end of the world if you're on the extreme end. Just do your research and make sure you're keeping fauna that can survive and thrive in those conditions. It's also important to note that most of the plants we keep in the aquascaping hobby prefer slightly acidic conditions. So aqua soil, specifically our UNS contrasoil, will buffer the pH. And we'll let you know what that means later in the video, but it'll actually bring the pH down slightly, which plants tend to really like. So it is quite desirable to maintain a planted aquarium that is slightly acidic. Now it's time to talk about what is actually dissolved in your water. And the most general sort of benchline way you can determine how much stuff is dissolved in your water is by taking a TDS reading. And TDS stands for total dissolved solids. And that's exactly what it sounds like. Water is very, very rarely just pure H2O. Most water, including most people's tap water, has some dissolved stuff in it. And TDS tells you exactly how much dissolved organic and inorganic compounds are in that water. Now, where TDS sort of fails us is it doesn't tell us what is dissolved in the water. It just gives you a reading. But this is a really, really good way to just get an initial benchmark of, okay, what kind of water is coming out of my tap? And TDS is measured typically in parts per millions, but you'll also see it in microsiemens sometimes. And generally speaking, in aquascaping, we find that keeping a TDS around 150 120 to 150 parts per million total dissolved solids is ideal. Now, some people have very, very hard water that is anywhere up to 700 part per million TDS, and they're able to keep successful planted aquariums. However, if you want to have the ideal situation and really maximize your chances for success, maintaining a TDS around 120 to 150 is going to give you a really nice start. However, because TDS doesn't tell you exactly what's measured in the water, it doesn't ensure that it has all of the required minerals you need. And that's where GH and KH can give you a little bit more information. So GH is the general hardness of your water, and GH is a measurement of the calcium and the magnesium in your water. So all plants need very, very trace amounts of calcium and magnesium. It goes for your fish and shrimp and snails too. Shrimp build their exoskeletons out of calcium, snails build their shells out of calcium, and then fish need it for bone growth. So it's very important that you have calcium and magnesium in your water. And GH is measured in degrees GH. And generally speaking, striving for a GH of around 5 to 8 degrees of hardness is a pretty good benchmark. However, you can also run a soft water aquascape that is in the 1 to 3 range. And some people run tanks that are very hard, anywhere from 20 plus degrees of GH. The important part is consistency. As with everything in aquascaping, you never want rapidly fluctuating parameters. So if you do find you have very, very hard water closer to that 20 GH mark, do some experiments, see how plants do, see how your fauna thrives. But again, if you want that really ideal planted aquarium where things are slightly acidic and on the softer end, aiming for that 5 to 8 degrees of GH is going to give you the best conditions. So where GH sort of lets us down is it tells us how much collectively magnesium and calcium is in the water, but it doesn't tell us how much of what is in the water. So your GH can be 100% calcium and you might be completely magnesium deficient. This is where, if necessary, it's important to go get individual magnesium and calcium tests to really see. Alternatively, you can look up your municipality's water quality report and see if they have numbers on magnesium and calcium. But if you want to take a more holistic approach, just look at the plants and look out for deficiencies. If everything is happy and thriving and growing well, odds are there's no deficiency in your GH. And next up we have KH, also known as carbonate hardness. And what KH does is it allows your water to resist downward pH swings. So in the hobby, you may hear a lot of people warning you against pH swings and pH crashes. And this is something that KH helps prevent. And KH typically exists in the aquarium as a carbonate ion. And the important thing to know about carbonate ions, without getting too much in the water chemistry, is that they are negatively charged. So as we mentioned earlier, the hydrogen ions, which make your water more acidic, are positively charged. So the negatively charged carbonate ion bonds to the positively charged hydrogen ion, they neutralize, and your pH does not get any lower. So they're able to maintain a sort of steady pH. The higher your KH, the more it'll bond to those hydrogen ions and prevent the pH from getting any lower. The lower your KH, the fewer carbonate ions exist, and the more the pH will creep down low, especially when you're running CO2. So as with GH, you can get by in the aquascaping hobby with a fairly wide range of KH, but an ideal KH to shoot for if you're a beginner or intermediate aquascaper and you want that safety net is 4 to 8 degrees of carbonate hardness. It's important to note that certain species require very, very low KH, and it's very, very important that KH is stable. This is the parameter that you want to really make sure is not fluctuating throughout the week. So if you're keeping delicate Caradina shrimp, for example, not only is it very important that you maintain a very low KH, it's highly important that that KH does not fluctuate. So as with everything else, just make sure your numbers are fairly consistent throughout the week and you'll have nothing to worry about. But if you do want to keep a special species, do some research, see what kind of KH they require, and figure out what you have to do to maintain that ideal KH. So how do you adjust these parameters and why would you want to do it in the first place? Many aquascapers find that their tap water is just not adequate for that ideal, slightly acidic planted aquarium. So many of us use a blank water slate in the form of pure water, also known as RODI water. And RODI stands for reverse osmosis deionized water. And this is just pure H2O. But remember, earlier we mentioned that pure H2O is not good. All the organisms we keep in our planet aquariums, they require some dissolved minerals. But starting with that blank slate of pure H2O allows you to sort of engineer the water exactly how you want it. And the way we reconstitute purified water so that it's ideal for the planted aquarium is by adding minerals back into the water. And you can find minerals in a variety of forms. Some add just GH, some add just KH, some add both. So go ahead and check out the Buce Plant website. We carry the SL Aqua line of water conditioners, and you'll find something for everything you're looking to adjust. And there are bottles specifically for GH and KH. If you have very soft water and you're looking to increase the hardness a bit, you can also add calcium-rich rocks like ceruite stone. Just do your research and know that a lot of these rocks also contain carbonates, so they're also going to raise the KH, which generally speaking is not a problem. But again, if you're keeping soft water ornamental shrimp, this is something to be cognizant of. As we mentioned earlier, using UNS Contrasoil is going to buffer the pH of your aquarium, and it's gonna keep the KH on the lower end. So it'll help maintain slightly acidic conditions. But if you need to maintain a very, very hard alkaline tank, maybe you're keeping African cichlids, or a similar species like that, you may wanna consider not using Aquasoil and instead using an inert gravel or some sand. And then finally, if you wanna lower your pH the natural way, you can also introduce some driftwood. Driftwood leaches tannins, and that helps lower the pH and keep things slightly acidic. So if your water is on the more basic end and you wanna bring that pH down, consider tossing some driftwood in. So even though we've decided to keep this lesson very, very basic, this can still seem like a lot. So when in doubt, just rewatch the portions of the videos that confuse you and head on over to the Buce Plant blog for very in-depth articles on each and every one of these parameters. But here are some basic tips to keep in mind when you're considering adjusting parameters and you're thinking about water chemistry. So first and foremost, take a holistic approach. Don't chase parameters, don't chase elements. Keep a very close eye on your fauna and your plants, and if things are going well, don't change anything. Just keep an eye on the life in your tank and use that to take a holistic approach to the aquarium. And also talk to other hobbyists in your area. If you don't know anything about the local water, join a Facebook group and ask other people what types of plants and fish and shrimp they're able to keep. And finally, whenever working with tap water, make sure that you're on the lookout for chlorines and chloramines. When in doubt, it's a very good idea to use a water conditioner to prevent any sort of chlorine burn. On BucePlant.com, we carry the SL Aqua line and they manufacture a water conditioner just for that exact purpose. So thank you so much for watching. Feel free to ask us any specific questions in the comments. And if there's a specific parameter you'd like to see a video on where we really deep dive into it, let us know down below in the comments. We love hearing from you. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Logan with Team Buce Plant, and we'll see you next time.